This month in Philadelphia, a first-of-its-kind law went into effect, mandating that all businesses accept physical dollar bills or coins in exchange for goods and services. Overall, the percentage of cash payments in the U.S. has been dropping from 33% to 26% in just the past 4 years. That's prompted some businesses to go entirely cashless, but not everyone is buying in. Brooke Silva Braga is here with more. Brooke, good morning.
Good morning, guys. This move away from cash comes as digital options like Apple Pay and PayPal have become more popular. Amazon has opened stores that automatically charge you for what you pull off the shelves. The cashless craze has also been embraced by lots of upscale, fast casual restaurants catering to city office workers. For some, these so-called frictionless transactions offer speed and convenience, but many Americans are still reliant on cash, and they have the support of an unlikely champion.
There's a good chance you know a guy like William Greenlee.
If you like the good old Philly cheesesteak, we can go right down here.
Okay. Chatty, salt of the earth type. The guy who slides up to a register.
I'll take one lemon.
And still pays cash.
And there we are.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
And so when Greenlee found a coffee shop right downstairs from his Philadelphia office that wouldn't take cash, well, that just rubbed him the wrong way.
Everybody comes in the center city, business, employment, entertainment, whatever.
But not everyone could buy a coffee.
Exactly. And not everyone can go in there and buy a basic product.
The thing is, Greenlee is a Philadelphia city councilman. And so he proposed and passed legislation making Philadelphia the first city in the country to force retailers to take cash.
Unfortunately, Philadelphia has been called the poorest big city in America, which means that, you know, there are people who do not have credit. Telling people who do not have the ability to have credit that you can't buy a basic product is not treating people fairly.
Poor people have a lot of serious problems.
Mm-hmm.
Why focus on the right to buy a $14 salad or a $5 coffee when there are other more pressing issues?
Well, I guess I would say we can do more than one thing at a time.
In an era of vast income inequality and skepticism over fast-moving tech, William Greenlee had stumbled upon a strangely galvanizing issue. San Francisco and New Jersey followed with similar bills. Legislators from New York City and Washington, D.C. have called him for advice.
I think it hit a nerve with people, to be perfectly honest with you.
What's the nerve?
You're telling me that I can't use the currency of the United States of America?
1415?
Just last year, cashless seemed cool. The owners of Dos Toros Taqueria told CBS News they rarely had to turn away customers wanting to use cash.
That's where everything's going. I know China's basically there already. India's halfway there.
Two Forks, another fast casual spot, touted the increased efficiency of going cashless.
With every cash transaction, the payment process was slowing down significantly.
What a difference a year has made. At least one cashless company, Sweetgreen, is now accepting cash again, and the others don't seem excited to talk about it. We reached out to every cashless company we could find, and none of them would speak to us on the record. In the past, they've argued cash is a headache to manage. It slows down the line and leaves stores vulnerable to theft.
You see this trend continuing. We won't be using cash.
We'll be using less and less.
Economics professor Ken Rogoff was willing to talk about the problems with cash. He's the author of The Curse of Cash and argues, among other things, hard money fuels crime.
Human trafficking, drug smuggling, big time tax evasion.
It would be better, he thinks, if we were more like Sweden, where cash has nearly been phased out. And the U.S. will get there too, Rogoff says, in another 5 or 10 years.
There's no question that cash, you know, is in its last era. Electronic payments are being favored by consumers. Forget the businesses. We're on the Harvard campus here. If you talk to my undergraduates, you know, they'll say, well, you know, what do we need cash for unless we're buying marijuana?
That's pretty funny.
If and when cash fades away, Rogoff has an idea for helping the 20 million Americans who live in unbanked households, meaning they don't have any bank or credit accounts.
It would not be that expensive to provide free basic debit cards to people. And a number of other countries have done this. India's done it. I mean, if India can afford to do it, we can afford to do it.
But the march from paper money to the digital future has taken a notable detour in Philadelphia. As the city considered its cashless ban, Amazon warned officials that the legislation would discourage them from opening a cashless Amazon Go store in Philly. But in the end, it was not William Greenlee who caved.
I understand Amazon Go, am I saying
that
right?
Yeah.
They do take cash. You know, they did not at first, and then they have decided to do it.
That might have something to do with you.
Well, maybe. Not just me, but I think the fact that this anti-cashless thing is spreading around, I think it did have something to do with it. I don't apologize for doing this. I think it's the right thing to do.
Greenlee told us that after the bill passed, Sweetgreen reached out to him and said they had never intended to give the impression that they were excluding certain customers.
When you still have 20 million unbanked Americans, you have to figure out some way forward without just saying we don't take any cash.
And this isn't just about salads. Obviously, as the economy is moving in this direction, more and more products will be harder to buy with cash, and that's what people are worried about.
You know,
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say maybe everyone should have a credit card of some kind issued by our jolly green giant. You know, I mean, let's be real here. That's what it's going to take if we're moving in that direction.
Yeah, that's what Rogoff, the professor, wants to see happen. Some countries have done it. Not easy to implement.
It's also, you look at the homeless on the streets now, with so few people carrying cash.
Yes.
That issue, and if it still is one for them, but you wonder if you could create some type of credit system for everyone. Could that change some of that? I know that's a completely different issue, but it is something out there without the cash.
Certainly is. Thank you.